this is a case of what goes around comes around, quite literally.
The 50s craze of hula hooping is back. I don't remember it, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not just popular with young people.
Hula hooping is all the rage overseas. They're hooping in the street, at home, in the park, indoors. Grandmas are hooping. There's even hoop idol. And now we're hooping down under. Thousands have gone round the bend for this sport. Classes and communities of hoop dancers are popping up everywhere, as Bunny Hoopstar explains.
If you're really serious about learning, yeah, a class is the perfect way to focus and direct your training into something that'll just be very rewarding. It's like a great workout, but you don't even realise that you're working out, and you're rocking out to your favourite tunes, and you have this dazzling, sparkling hoop spinning around your body.
These advanced hoopers are using custom-made hoops, which are individually sized, weighed and decorated. There's hoop yoga, and you can even hula in the dark. The origins of hula hooping are unknown, but people have toyed with hoops throughout history. In the 14th century, doctors even encouraged heart attack patients to give it a go.
Any age range, any skill level, you've just got to want to learn and have fun, really.
Most of us had a go at hula hooping during our childhood, which got me to thinking, how hard can it actually be? And no, I'm not going to embarrass myself on national television. I'm going to leave that to some other people.
Hula hoop, hula hoop. Everyone is playing with the hula hoop. I looked at them spin, trying to win. Anyone can play from three.
Perhaps it's best left to the experts. Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.